अथ पञ्चदशोऽध्यायः श्रीभगवानुवाच ऊर्ध्वमूलम् अधःशाखम् अश्वत्थम् प्रापुरव्ययम् छन्दांसि यस्य पर्णानि यस्तं वेद स वेदवित्।
The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, "It is said that there is an imperishable banyan tree that has its roots upward and its branches down and whose leaves are the Vedic hymns. One who knows this tree is the knower of the Vedas."
अधश्चोर्ध्वं प्रसृताः तस्य शाखाः गुणप्रवृद्धाः विषयप्रबालाः अधश्च मूलानि अनुसन्ततानि कर्मानुबन्धीनि मनुष्यलोके।
The branches of this tree extend downward and upward, nourished by the three modes of material nature. The twigs are the objects of the senses. This tree also has roots going down, and these are bound to the fruit of actions of human society.
Narupamasyeha tathopalabhyate nanto na chadihi na cha sampratishtha अश्वत्थमेनं सुविरूढमूलं असङ्गशस्त्रेण दृढेन चित्वा ततःपदं तत्परिमार्गितव्यं यस्मिन् गता न निवर्तन्ति भूयः तमेव चाद्यं पुरुषं प्रपद्ये यतः प्रवृत्तिः प्रसृता पुराणी।
The real form of this tree cannot be perceived in this world. No one can understand where it ends, where it begins, or where its foundation is. But with determination, one must cut down the strongly rooted tree with a weapon of detachment. Thereafter, one must seek that place from which, having gone, one never returns, and there surrender to that Supreme Personality of Godhead, from whom everything began and from whom everything has extended since time immemorial.
Nirmana Bodha Jita Sangha Dosha Adhyatma Nitya Vinivritta Kamaha द्वन्द्वैर्विमुक्ताः सुखदुःखसंज्ञैः गच्छन्त्यमूढाः पदमव्ययं तत्।
Those who are free from false prestige, illusion and false association, who understand the eternal, who are done with material lust, who are freed from the dualities of happiness and distress, and who, unbewildered, know how to surrender unto the Supreme Person, attain to that eternal kingdom.
Na tad bhasayate suryo na shashanko na pavakah yad gatva na nivartante tad dham paramam Mama.
That supreme abode of mine is not illumined by the sun or moon, nor by fire or electricity. Those who reach it never return to this material world.
Mamaivamsho jivaloke jivabhutah sanatanah manashchani इंद्रियाणि प्रकृतिस्थानि क karshati.
The living entities in this conditioned world are my eternal fragmental parts. Due to conditioned life, they are struggling very hard with the six senses, which include the mind.
Shariram yadavapnoti yachapyutkramati shvaraha grihitvaitani samyati vayuhu gandhani vashayat.
The living entity in the material world carries his different conceptions of life from one body to another, as the air carries aromas. Thus, he takes one kind of body and again quits it to take another.
Shrotram chakshuhu sparshanam cha rasanam ghranameva cha adhishthaya manashchayam vishayan upasevate.
The living entity, thus taking another gross body, obtains a certain type of ear, eye, tongue, nose and sense of touch, which are grouped about the mind. He thus enjoys a particular set of sense objects.
Utkramantam sthitam vapi bhunjanam vagunanvitam vimudha nanu pashyanti pashyanti jnana chakshushaha.
The foolish cannot understand how a living entity can quit his body, nor can they understand what sort of body he enjoys under the spell of the modes of nature. But one whose eyes are trained in knowledge can see all this.
Yatanto yoginashchainam pashyanti atmanyavastitam yatanto api akritatmano nainam pashyanti achetasaha.
The endeavoring transcendentalists, who are situated in self-realization, can see all this clearly. But those whose minds are not developed and who are not situated in self-realization cannot see what is taking place, though they may try.
Yadadityagatam tejo jagadbhasayate akhilam yachandramasi yachagno tatejo vidhi mamakam.
The splendor of the sun, which dissipates the darkness of this whole world, comes from me, and the splendor of the moon and the splendor of fire are also from me.
Gama vishyacha bhutani dharayamyagamojasa pushnami chaushadhihi sarvah soma bhutva rasatmakah.
I enter into each planet and by my energy they stay in orbit. I become the moon and thereby supply the juice of life to all vegetables.
Aham vaishvanaro bhutva praninam dehamashritaha pranapana samayuktaha pachamyannam chaturvidham.
I'm the fire of digestion in the bodies of all living entities, and I join with the air of life, outgoing and incoming, to digest the four kinds of foodstuff.
Sarvasya chaham hrudi sannivishto mattah smritir jnanam apohanam cha vedaischa sarvaihi ahameva vedyo vedanta krit vedavideva chaham.
I'm seated in everyone's heart, and from me come remembrance, knowledge and forgetfulness. By all the Vedas, I am to be known. Indeed, I am the compiler of Vedanta, and I am the knower of the Vedas.
Dvavimau purusho loke kshara kshara evacha kshara sarvani bhutani kutastho akshara ujjati.
There are two classes of beings, the fallible and the infallible. In the material world, every living entity is fallible, and in the spiritual world, every living entity is called infallible.
Uttamaha purushastu anyaha paramatmeti udahritaha yo lokatrayam avishya vibharti avyayaha ishwaraha.
Besides these two, there is the greatest living personality, the Supreme Soul, the imperishable Lord Himself, who has entered the three worlds and is maintaining them.
Yasmat charam atitokam aksharadapicha uttamaha atosmi loke vedecha prathitaha purushottamaha.
Because I am transcendental, beyond both the fallible and the infallible, and because I am the greatest, I am celebrated both in the world and in the Vedas as that Supreme Person.
Yo mamevam asammudho janati purushottamam sasarvavit bhajati maam sarvabhavena bharata.
Whoever knows me as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, without doubting, is the knower of everything. He therefore engages himself in full devotional service to me, O son of Bharata.
Iti gukhyatamam shastram idam uktam mayanagha etat buddhva buddhimam syat krita krityascha bharata.
This is the most confidential part of the Vedic scriptures, O sinless one, and it is disclosed now by me. Whoever understands this will become wise, and his endeavors will know perfection.